tribulations, and I go through them Monday through Saturday. So, devil, you ain't a taking my son. Hallelujah. Are you going to put on some skin?
That's right.
Yep.
I'm talking about some Holy Ghost filled fireball. Anointing and blessed skin.
Oh, yes.
So I'm asking everyone to get into this service.
Hallelujah.
Because I'm telling you, I know God is going to do some great mighty things this morning.
Amen.
I know I say it all the time, but it's been right all the time. Amen. We're two or more gathered together in my name. There am I in the midst. Amen.
Amen.
So as they come up, get into this service.
Hallelujah. Tony,
I want, you know, we're not Hollywood up here, but we feel the Lord when we're doing this. I want you to look as many times as the devil pulled and tugged at your chains. I want you to watch Jesus fight for you, just you only.
Amen.
You're here today with chains weighing you down. This altar's open. There's people
who
pray for you. Amen. crowd.
That's right. That's right. Hallelujah.
Jesus came home. the guitars and drums and say, hey, I play the banjo. And I'll tell you what, he's done a fine job. You're doing good, man. And you know what? Stick with us, you'll learn a lot more.
Amen.
Amen. He's fine. How old is he? How old are you? 14 up here standing in front of the people.
Yeah.
He came
your chains has more power over you than God has over you. But I want to tell you something. I serve an almighty, all-seeing, all-knowing God. Not even death has power over my mother. In the prayers of a righteous man avail much. If you want to get down to business with God, He'll get down to business with you.
Thank you.
That's just how it is, church. It's about time that we shake them things off. Chains of alcoholism, with chains of drug addiction, with chains of lust, with chains of deceit, with chains of grudge. They've got so much on them, amen. They want to do good, but it seems like that this thing that's got a hold of them is bigger than they are. But the Bible says that it's through your weakness that His strength is made perfect. He may cast all your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. Can He not break your chains? If the God
change.
See, we got people that says, you know what, would you pray for me? Oh, I need prayer. I need delivered from this. But yet turn around and the chains that they want delivered from, they take and they caress it and they hold it and they sleep with it night after night. They take it with them day after day. But the Bible says that we're a new creature in Christ. Merciful God, and in that labeled as a deadbeat. Maybe you've been labeled as a drug head. Maybe you've been labeled as an old drunken sot. But let me tell you something. They're looking at your past, or they're looking at what you're doing right now. But if you'll give your heart to the Lord, it don't matter what they label you. What does God label you? He said, "They're my child." I'm speaking now. Vehicle, those chains, they couldn't shut the door yet because they had to pull the chains. Oh, your door didn't shut all the way. It's because I got my chains caught. The next thing you know, it becomes part of their wardrobe for the charm. They go to Walmart. Even if they're going to get a loaf of bread, they got to get a buggy because they can't bear to tag along their chain. They have to hold their chain.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
They go in there hoping and praying that maybe they'll meet somebody that might say something that could get them out of this mess. They're just like the man that stayed there by the pool of Bethesda and said, "I have no man to put me in the pool." But Jesus, little did he know that Jesus was there. And Jesus was saying, with you and leave them. when you go. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. I can see somebody down on their knees ready to give up and the chains has weighed them down. But then that person begins to be able to raise their hand and say, there's power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Now listen to this, church. He just got close to the man. He didn't even get a chance to talk to him. And then the evil spirits began to talk. Stand to be bound down. Yeah. I'll never forget his natural instinct. A buddy of mine made a bad mistake one time. My brother was with me. We was working over, I think it's in Illinois. And a friend of mine, out of the blue, runs up from behind and grabs me. Good size boy. And squeezes. Before I knew it, I twisted and threw him. He went in midair underneath a 10-wheeler truck that was parked and busted his head open.
Wow.
I said, don't grab me.
Amen.
That's it, Tommy.
Amen.
Are you all right? You bleeding, son. And I apologized. I said, you okay? And then he said, no, it was my fault. I shouldn't grab him.
Amen.
The devil ought to know better.
Yes.
Than to grab him. You see what I'm saying? Don't give him time to sit there and take it.
Amen.
The devil needs to fear her. No, I'm not. No, I'm not getting on her back. I am not going to even try to keep up with him. You see, we make it too easy for the devil, brother Jim. See, we make it too easy because we can't move like we used to move because we carry our chains with us. Amen. But when the devil looks and says, uh-oh, they ain't got their chains with them. My God, they can move today. I'm getting ready to come to the close. I feel the Lord speaking.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I feel God talking to some people here this morning. I want to ask if you close your eyes. God's speaking to you. I don't know your situation. I don't know what it is you're going through. And honestly, it's really not any of my business. See, I can't help you like Jesus can.
Amen.
You see, Jesus, he's here.
Yes.
Amen.
And he wants to take care of you.
Yes.
See, Jesus right now is calling your name. And he's asking you, are you tired of the chains? Are you tired of being labeled as a no account? Are you tired of hearing the chains? First thing every morning when you wake up. Last thing when you lay in the bed. Are you sick and tired of not being able to hold your hands up? Have you lost your smile? Have you lost your happiness? Maybe because somebody done you wrong so many times. So what? I know somebody that'll never do you wrong. I know somebody that loves you more than anyone could ever love you. So I'm asking right now, if God is speaking to your heart, will you come to this altar? Please. I'm begging you, come to this altar. If you want the Lord, and you're tired of these chains, you've got them coming. Deacon, honey, you come here and pray. Yes, Lord. I'm going to keep this going. Would you pray with her? She's one of the church. You know what? Matter of fact, would you pray? weight, the longer the chain becomes. And the longer the chain becomes, the heavier the chain becomes. And the heavier that the chain becomes, Brother Mac, the slower you get. The more life you lose. There's a young lady that says, I'm done. I'm done of trying my way. My way just don't work. Thank you. filled with people that say, I want to be different. Nor can your daddy. Your pastor can't saving? Only Jesus. You can't even save yourself. Would there be any others as they're praying? Any
Thank you.